Yes, hi everyone. So our team name is Scrum League. Yellow ones are the insights, and the pink ones are the future trends that we see from the report. So the first observation from the report is that only 7% believe that senior management endorses and supports adoption of Scrum. The second observation, I mean, some of the observations have already been discussed, so we won't discuss that. And the second point is that only 10% of respondents say that they hold retrospective meetings, whereas, 79% hold retrospective and 10% people, they don't hold retrospective meetings. So that is the trend there. And 81% of people believe that certification has helped them to adopt Scrum methodologies. So people who are looking for certification, I think they are on the right track, including myself. And most of the organizations are following a hybrid model of Agile. Okay, and another insight is that Scrum is reaching beyond IT. So Scrum is reaching beyond IT means it is product development, operations, healthcare, finance, and all of the office. Another observation is that Scrum is challenging when other groups in the company, they don't use Scrum. So adopting Scrum in that scenario is a challenge. Okay, regarding Agile methodology, 54% of the respondents say that they are using Scrum in addition to some other Agile methodology. And 42% people say they are using exclusively using Scrum methodology. And 93% people say they are using some form of Scrum. Now on to the future trends that we observe. Scrum is slowly scaling at the enterprise level. And in future, I think there's going to be a need for strong collaboration between cross-functional teams and organizations. And Scrum certification is going to be a necessity. Right now, it's but in future, it's going to be a necessity if you want to get into the Scrum practice. And there's going to be transition from all the waterfall-based approaches to Scrum approach. Okay, I think this point has already been discussed that the PM role is at risk. So PM role will be taken over by Scrum Master. Another one on the role is that the product owner role, I think it's going to be the most important role, and I think it's going to be overlapping with the business analyst role.
Actually, traditionally we are having the dedicated tester, and it increases our work in process, because if testers are only testers are expected to do the final testing and integration in that case, and now future trend will be that as soon as the one item will be completed, it will be tested and integrated. So everybody will do some level of testing. It will be the future trend.
I think automation will help reduce that cost instead of manual testing.
What is happening right now, the mindset of developers who are in waterfall,
they have
mindset tester will do testing only. Lot
of things are in finding status.
Right.
Because we are expecting the things will go in the testing pipeline. And then it will be integrated.
So in other words, tester designation is at risk. Everyone will become developer and tester.
See, many of them who want to do behavior-driven development, right, BDD,
I really see opposition from the QA because they feel their job is at risk. PDD especially, it's a very good technique, but opposition psychologically people are opposing.
In the world, developers also do unit testing for their projects.
No, but PDD is scenario-based testing, where you normally expect a QA person.
So user acceptance-driven testing, you can say. The first you create the user acceptance test, like how the user will see the application, and then you start writing the code.
So the developer himself writes the Jenkins language and the PDD. So team feels their job is at risk.
So actually, I work in a project with 70 people of projects. Now actually, developers themselves are doing their automation testing. First thing, the developer takes the development of the story, then they will write the automation script, which is a JavaScript routine. And so for automation, all the testers are there to automate the backlog items, not the current users having the last three.
Yes, definitely.
So all the automation.
We are doing testing manually, so how difficult is it for the tester to test the entire functionality? Apart from those changes, some refactoring thing. So if it is automated, so we need to just execute the script for the sprint one and create script for the second sprint. Yeah, so that's what we So there is another thing regarding the, you can say, the one minute. So one thing is, when you talk about scrum, the future, the one aspect is to use scrum in large teams. So we are talking about 100 people team, we are talking about the scalable framework, so that is one thing. But at the same time, we are talking about using agility within the organization's other operational areas. We do the development in our development environment, so the integration, the IT infrastructure department, so that is separate. So once we do everything for the sprint and we give them, okay, this is why you to keep it. So that by the time we complete the minimum marketable feature, you can just start using this internally. So at that time, the difference came. We do development at our box. The actual production environment is altogether different. So at the same time, we have our admin department, our operation, our resource. So those, all the departments need to contribute into the agility. So that's the call of the time. So we are facing a lot of problems due to this. So we have some people in the operation already. So they have their processes. So we were expecting some hardware from the outside, from the client. So as per Agile, so we planned that sprint, okay, we will get that hardware. But they have their own process. They say, okay, first we will go to this invoice, then we need the picture of that particular printer that I'm talking about. So they have their own processes, they want to fulfill it. They want to place order and everything, but we want them to be agile, right? Because we are talking about delivering value in the 4 week of sprints, right? So all the departments should take part in that. So
organization level agility.
Yes, exactly.
Great. So the rest of the questions during the breaks. Thank you. Yeah. Yeah.